नमस्कार। आप सभी लोग अपने अपने घरों पर सकुशल होंगे। इसी आशा के साथ हम अपने सीधे बात करते हैं। इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द रेगुलेशंस ऑफ द जीन्स एक्सप्रेशंस इन विच वी हैव टॉक अबाउट हाउ द लैक ऑपरेंस इनिशिएटेड और हाउ द इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द इंड्यूसर्स इट कैन बी सोर्स एंड कैन डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द बीटा गैलेक्टोसाइडेज पायरिमिडेज एंड द ट्रांस एसिटाइलेज राइट एज वेल एज in the absence of inducer the process is not completed over there. So let's move to another topic that is most important topic, that is the human genome project. Means first of all we have to know what is this human genome project, especially if we talk about, at least this is a very important project which can be just used, take at least 13 years for the by the US department for the energy and the National Institute of the Health, which can be just completed the project within 13 years, especially the US Department of Energy and the National Institute, they coordinated for this one and they can be launched this project especially in 1990, which is generally completed into the 2003. And if we talk about that, it can be closely associated with the rapid development of the new area in biology, that is called bioinformatics. Especially we can say this human genome project contains a different, it can be shows a rapid changes in the genes. Rapid means it can be always helpful for the specific new conditions, right? Or new branch of the biology, that is we can say that is bioinformatics. And this HGP was also known as the mega project because of its specific conditions. Why it is mega? Mega means बहुत बड़ा. आखिर में इसको HGP को एक बहुत बड़ा project माना गया. Why? Because there are some specific things. There are some specific things that we can say the total cost of this project, that is approx $9 billion, and the total store of the information in it will requires at least 3,300 books, at least books of the 1,000 pages, right? And if the 1,000 letters are written in one pages over there, means you can just think the total that books contains, the number of books, that is 3,300, and each book has 1,000 pages and each page has 1,000 letters in that one. So that's why it is a mega project. And another thing we can say, need a high speed of computational devices to store, retrieve and analyze the information, and generally for that the different computer like things needed for the getting or gathering of this information over there. And if we talk about the different goals of this HGP, because sometimes the goals can be asked about, goals mean why it is required, especially for the requirement of this HGP, human genome project, was that we can say it can be always helpful for the identifying all the approximately 20,000 to 25,000 genes in the human DNA. Means this project can be always helpful to understand, to identify all those genes, 20,000 to 25,000 genes which are found in the human DNA. And this can also help for the determining the sequences of the 3 billion chemicals basis pair that made up of the human DNA. Means generally the human DNA is made up of at least 3 billion chemicals bases, which can be sequences, can also be evenly. It can be also help for or store the information in the database. Means this information can be also stored in a data one evenly. It can also help for the improve the tools of the data analyzing, and it can also to transfer the related technologies to the other sectors such as industries. Means the this substances can be also utilized for the different other categories in different industries sector also. And evenly we can say it can also help for the addresses the ethical, legal and social issues, means LC, that can arise from the project. Means there are lots of issues can be also found over there, that is known as ethical, legal and social issues that may be arises from this project. Means generally with the help of this project, the different things can be also understand with the another thing. So it can be always helpful for some other things. Evenly. Especially the this human genome project, there are some specific methodologies on the basis of which can be done. That is, in the first we can say the express sequence tags, that is we can say ESTs. Especially under these conditions, this is the method based for the identifying the all genes that are expressed as RNA. Means that it is it, with the help of this we can all get the informations identifying all the genes which are expressed as the RNA. On the other hand, the second one we can say that is the sequence annotations. It means sequence annotations, it can be always helpful for the sequencing the whole set of genome, coding and the non-coding sequences, later different in region where the assigned in sequence obtained based on the it's a function. I mean where they can be functionalized. The इसमें completely whole set लेते हैं the first appearing sequences text में especially with the different genes which can be identified or the method in which we can identify all the genes which can be expressed for the RNA. But in the sequence annotations in which we have to get the whole gene sequence or the set of genome one, right? Both even it is a coding or it is a non-coding sequences, and they can be always helpful for the different functions. On the basis of that, the if we can talk about the sequencing, that the total DNA from the cell which can be isolated and converted into the relative smaller size as fragment. Generally, the total sequence of the DNA can be isolated and it can be converted into the different fragments, conditional small fragments, right? And after that they can be get another thing that we can say the directly those DNA fragments are cloned in a suitable host using special vectors. Especially cloning conditions means we can needed the some vectors on which we have to just clone those sequences which can be isolated or fragmented over there. So we can say that DNA fragments are cloned in a suitable, means they can be cloned, developed in a suitable host using a special vectors like the yeast and the bacteria, right? So in that particular conditions we they have started to use the bacteria, that is known as the bacterial artificial chromosomes, that is called BAC, and another one that is called YAC, that is yeast artificial chromosome, right? Where they can be done the such conditions. So we can say the host bacteria and the yeast cloning DNA sequences with the help of the amplification of each DNA fragments. Means there is another process, that is amplification of the DNA with the help of this host bacteria or the host yeast, due to which it will started to grown up. And in the same time we can say that the fragments of DNA, they can be sequenced by the automated DNA sequences with generally on the basis of the Sanger's experiments, or developed by the, we can say that is the principle of the Sanger, which is known as, or that Sanger has developed a principle on the basis of which the fragment of DNA are sequenced to automated, means they can be automated sequences are done over there. And those sequences, these automated sequences, we can say they are arranged according to the on the basis of the overlapping region on the DNA fragments, means they have the overlapping. एक DNA के ऊपर जो segments होगा वो दूसरा sequence आ जाएगा same condition free, right? तो उसी को कहते हैं क्या overlapping region of the DNA segments. And later on the arrangements of these sequences based on the computer program are developed. I mean generally they can be aligned, they can be attached by computer developing programs over there. And at the last we can say the genetic and the physical maps of the genome are constructed. Means generally their map, their paper, their structure can be done on the paper, that is called a genome constructed by the collecting, right? Means generally we will get the all the informations from there and we will can capable to make a physical map over there, right? About that, the repetitive DNA sequences and DNA polymerization, means how the DNA sequence is repeated as well as the how it can be grown up and how it can polymerize over there. So with the help of these methodologies we can get the total human genome project. Later on we can say As you can see in the diagram, this is the representative especially for human genome project, means the organism cells, and there is a, that is chromosome, inside the chromosome there is DNA, and the total information of that DNA can be just stored in the formation of the software, especially with the help of the computer, which can be given us the different conditions for the cloning and some other things over there. Later on we have known about the different silent features of the human genome project. What are the different features? We can say that there are generally the human genome contains at least 3164.7 million nucleotide bases over there. Right? Means the human genome contains, the human genome is there, 3164.7 million nucleotide base pair are found over there. And if we can say the average gene consists of the 3000 bases, if we can talk that the average genes consisting of the 3000 bases, but the size is very greatly within the large known as human gene, being dystrophin of the 2.5 million, right? Lekin generally vary karte hai size is very greatly within the largest, generally jo hamare paas largest known hai human gene, its size is at least that is being to be dystrophin of the 2.4 million bases are already over there. And the total number of genes are estimated at least 30,000, right, which is much lower than the previous estimated, that is 80,000 to 140,000 genes, right? Almost all the 99% nucleotide bases are exactly the same in all peoples. I mean, generally if we can talk about the genes, the total estimated genes, they are 30,000, right? But later on, if we all know that previously they are estimated as that 80,000 to 140,000 genes are found over there. Means previously pehle estimate kiya gaya tha ki lagbhag lagbhag itne genes honge, lekin the total number of genes estimated jo nikal gaya hai wo kya tha, that is 30,000, right? Means generally jo pehle estimate kiya gaya usse jo starting mein estimate kiya tha 30,000 ka, lekin usse bahut zyada baad mein hamare paas genes nikal ke aaye, right? To iske alawa we can say the function of unknown for over 50% of the discovered genes. Generally 50% jo genes hamare discovered hai, their function is not unknown, their function abhi bhi clear nahi hai. Evenly we can say that less than 2% of the genome code for the proteins, keval less than 2% genome hi protein ko code karte hain. Evenly we can say the repeated sequences make up very large portion of the human genome, and the repeated sequences of the stressed of the DNA sequences that can be repeated many times, sometimes 100 to 1000 times, then they thought to have no direct coding functions but shed light the chromosome structure dynamic and evolution. Means generally they can be not have shows any specific function, but they can be always shows the structural and sub changes during the evolution also. Evenly the chromosome 1 has most gene, that is 2968, and the Y gene, that is we can say fewest, that is 231 over there. And the scientists have identified about 1.4 million locations where there is single base DNA differences, single nucleotide polymorphism, or we can say SNP. As I have told you, especially with the help of this, there two conditions are found, how much that their DNA representative sequences and the DNA polymorphism. So especially the DNA differences or that is SNP, that is known as the single nucleotide polymorphism, occur in the especially in the human being. So these are different features, characters of this human gene project. And if we talk about the functions, especially the applications, right, that we can say the applications of human genome project or HGP, that we know the knowledge from the DNA sequences will be defined as the means generally the total knowledge which we can get from the DNA sequences, it can be used for the research and our knowledge of the biological system and about the total biological system also. And it can be also helpful for the new approaches of the biological research. Evenly, we can say it can be used for the study of the genes and genomes, and it can be also help to create a new ways of the diagnose, treat and prevent of the disorders that are affected the human bodies. And in non-human model organisms such as we can say the elegans and the Drosophila, rice, Arabidopsis has also been sequenced. Means with the help of this human genome project, we can get also some different conditions through which we can also understand to know some non-human models also about the especially bacteria, yeast and some other organisms over there. That is, we can say elegans, especially we can say Canohabitis elegans, that is a free known living pathogen nematodes. It is a nematode organism. Drosophila as a fruit fly plants, especially that is rice and the Arabidopsis, right? So on the their study can be also take place, and it can also helpful for the different sequences and different ways. So you must know all those things, especially about the why it is a mega project, their regions, their methodologies, silent picture of HGP and the applications of the this HGP program over there. So as you can just see, there are 246 base pairs and data around 50 million base pairs are over there. So with the help of this all, we all can understand especially about all these sequences in the such category that they are very important in conditions. So you must know and you must understand about all the such things which are very necessary, especially about the silent features. Evenly, there, as I have told you, that our silent features, especially there are 3,164.7 million nucleotide base pair, and the 300 base pairs are also over there. Evenly, if we can say that in the total, generally in the starting, the total estimated was 30,000, but there after that they can get the another thing, right? Especially as in the previously they have estimated about the 80 to 140,000 genes are, but after according to the human genome project there is 30,001, and in all nucleotide base pair exactly same in all human beings, that is 99.9. means we can say the all 99.9 nucleotide base pair are exactly same in the peoples, right? And we can say less than 22% of the genes genome code for the protein. So these are different features through which we can understand easily, so on. Evenly, as I have told you one more thing, that is we can say the different and the scientists have the identified about 1.4 million locations where the single base pair base DNA differences, that is SNP, right, means the single nucleotide polymorphism are generally occurs over there, right, in the especially in the human beings. So this information promises that the regularization and the processes of the finding chromosomal locations for the disease associated sequences and the tracing human history. So they can be always helpful for the different ways in different mechanisms. I think everybody will understand. So students, you must try to write all such things in properly